Yo, what is good, YouTube? It is tayrulez here, and I'm sorry, I know. It's been 2 weeks since I posted a video. A couple days before I took my little hiatus, I said that I was gonna start pushing out more content, and then I just take like a 2 week break off YouTube. I know, that's very bad of me to do that. I just had a lot of real life stuff going on right now. I had to go to New York for like a couple days. Really unexpected, I wasn't expecting to do that. So it really caught me off guard, and I didn't make videos in advance because that's what would I have liked to have done if I was going to go off for a couple days, and I never got around to doing it. So that's my bad. I'm sorry. And also, I'm going to address this. I'm working on a 2K wishlist as we speak right now. Should be coming up any day right now, but it's kind of just taking a while to get it all going because I'm adding in a lot of stuff to my wishlist and ads and whatnot. So it's coming. Do not worry. Now, I'm making an MLB The Show video here today because this is literally all I've been playing as of late. MLB The Show, Diamond Dynasty, I've been addicted to it. I took like a month break off of it, and now I'm back at it because, you know, it's baseball. I love baseball. I don't even know why I took that long of a break off of it. Mainly because of 2K16. I was grinding 2K, but I kind of just got fed up with it, and I just stopped playing it. I haven't played it in like a month or so. So, you guys see, this is a completely new team here. I edited a lot of players out. I mean, not players, but I definitely made a lot of roster moves. You can go back to the beginning of the video to see all the updates because there was literally too many updates that I made for this team. Now, going into this gameplay here, you see how laggy this game is. This was ridiculous how laggy this first game was. Oh, spoiler alert, there's going to be two videos. There's going to be two games in this video, so. This game was just ridiculously laggy. We got Garrett Cole pitching, who's really good. He's a great pitcher. If you need a cheap gold pitcher, this is definitely a good pitcher to use. He's a flamer. He has a really nice curveball. I don't usually use a slider all that much, but I've only used him like 2-3 times. I think this is like only the third time I've used him this game. This guy's team wasn't really good. I'm just letting you know right now, this guy, if you didn't see his lineup already, he had nothing but silvers and bronzes. He had Nomar Mazara at center field. Or I think they had center field. Nomar Mazara is a beast, but he's only a bronze, so. This guy really didn't have that good of a team. So, we're going into the second inning now, and I'm really just trying. This is Vince Velasquez, who isn't terrible. He isn't really all that good, so I'm able to get a hold of it, and you see the lag here. It's really terrible. The lag just was not good this game, so I just skipped ahead of it, and we're just dinging along. I mean, we're just getting some good single hits. Nothing really into the gap or anything, but we're getting some good solid contact on these pitches. We got Garrett Cole pitching. This play right here summed up this game. Look at this crap. Like, what? I was in total disbelief when I saw that play. The announcer says that it's a triple, or that he got by him, yet it's an out. And it was because of the lag. As you see, I was just in total disbelief at this play, so I went back and looked at it, and I don't know. This guy's internet was really bad. He had, like, that McDonald's Wi-Fi internet or some shit. I don't know. As you see, Prince Fielder trying to make a play, and then Ian Kinsler. If I wouldn't have dove with Prince Fielder, then I would have gotten him out. But, of course, I had to dive at Prince Fielder, and then this dude lines out. I can't even see what it is. Lines out the Corey Seager. So now we got Ichiro back up. Ichiro does what Ichiro does, and this actually was really lucky. And now looking at it, we're hit right off the center fielder's glove. But Ichiro, all he does is get hits. Next at bat, we got Carl Crawford up as well. That Carl Crawford, Ichiro Suzuki combo is really nice. And then Prince Fielder is next up at bat, and he's going to find the hole right down the middle, and he's going to get it. And like I said, the lag. And this play right here is about to be hilarious. Just look at this. So I tell Ichiro to run before he even makes the third. The game lags. He runs, and I'm safe somehow. He misses the tag. Ain't that some shit. And then Corey Seager, the god, he hits another hit. Corey Seager, I think he's easily my best player on my team. He just, all he does is just score and get hits. And then, of course, Adrian Beltre. When I first got Adrian Beltre, I was getting really pissed off with him because he just wouldn't hit the ball right. All that would happen was that he would get lineouts or strikeout. And then as of late, I've been hitting the ball really well with him. As I believe that was Garrett Cole that got another hit. I'm not really sure, actually. I can't really see the screen all that well for some reason. But yeah, I think it was Garrett Cole. But anyway, he's going to ground out almost into a double play, but it was to the first baseman. So luckily it wasn't a double play here. And then Prince Fielder gets hit. He is not happy about it, but we'll see what he can do when he gets back up to the plate. Corey Seager maybe try to avenge him. And nope. Oh, okay. But, you know, of course, my luck. It would hit off the first baseman's glove and it find the second baseman. You know, that's just... this is amazing. Garrett Cole just keeping him in a standstill. He's making him swing and miss. This guy really wasn't that good. I was really hoping for this guy to quit because it just was kind of a waste playing this guy. He really wasn't that good. I think he only had that one hit that went off of that Ian Kinsler got, and the first baseman wasn't there, but that's really about it. And then right off the wall. I thought he could have caught this one. I guess he didn't know how to dive, but I thought that could have been an easy play to catch. And then Ian Kinsler breaks his bat, and yep, to the second or to first base. And then we got Salty. Another one of those plays where it goes right off the pitcher, and that's the end of the inning. So that's how that ended. And then of course we got Garrett Cole just pitching really good. Like I said, this guy really wasn't that good, so I really wasn't expecting him to, you know, come back in this game. I was just expecting him just to quit out of this. But anyway, I'm looking to get more diamond players because I've been doing a bunch of the conquest games, and I want to get some more players other than just that because you guys probably see those players a lot. And, okay, this guy is going to end up going in the pause menu, and he's just going to end up sitting there for 5 minutes. Instead of just quitting. I don't know why. So we're gonna hop straight into the next game and let's see what this guy's roster is like. All right.
Oh, hell no! Oh, you motherfuckers. Okay. All right.
And is it really surprising that I'm going to go up against a God Squad after going up against that one scrub? I don't think it's that much of a coincidence, man. So, as we see here, Jose Altuve, game doesn't start off all that hot for me with Jose Altuve getting on base. So, I'm just expecting this to blow out. As we see here, we get a line out to left field. And, man, my butthole is clenching this entire damn game. This guy's team... easily a 96-97 overall. He had the Jackie Robinson, Reggie Stocker, Alex Rodriguez. This man's team was just loaded. I mean, I never understood how much time people could invest in this game, or like how much money you can invest in this, because this team easily was like $300-$400. If you think about it, how much stubs cost? Like I think $100K is like $100. So these guys are dropping huge money on these players, and I can't stack up to that. There's no way I'm spending that much money on this game, unless I'm getting paid off of YouTube or something. That's the only way I'd pay for that, is if I'm making big bank off of YouTube. Like, I'm not spending hard-earned money for a team like that, but I'm pretty content with the team right now. As we see, we're just not getting anything going. I'm not even gonna lie, this was a super slow game. TANNER Roark on the mound. It was like Cy Young possessed this man. And hold up. Corey Seager showing up on the ESPN Sports Center top plays. Look at this diving catch, robbing Joe Mauer of a hit. This was a lit play right here. And I just said lit. Yes, I said lit. This was such a nice play because usually I don't get those diving catches, but Corey Seager. Man, Corey Seager's just the best player on my team. No doubt about it. And there's a reason why that was only number two. if you noticed it, I only put it as number two and the top plays. Just keep on watching. Just keep on watching and you'll see why. But like I said, this Jose Fernandez, I felt like I was making good swings with him, but they're just finding gloves. You know those games where like you feel like you're getting solid contact on the ball, but they're just either finding lineouts or they're just popping up or groundouts. Like, I couldn't figure out why I couldn't just get good solid hits with him. So like I said, this was just a pitcher's duel for like the first couple innings. I couldn't tell if this guy was just not that good or I was just pitching really well. I will say, I didn't lose control of the ball most of the game. Like, whenever I aimed the ball at a certain spot, it was going to that spot. Like, it was one of the best pitching games I think I've ever had. And you guys will see going on later, this was just a great pitching by me. And I'm not even being cocky, but this is amazing. As we see Ian Kinsler getting on base, hopefully we can get some done. But unfortunately, we got freaking Tanner Roark. So I'm just trying to look down to get a sacrifice bunt. And unfortunately, it was hit way too hard and it got Ian Kinsler out. But Tanner Roark was fine. But let's see if we can at least get Ichiro and then nope, jams me up, pop out. Or at least that's what you think. Ichiro seems to just get those really stupid hits and it usually doesn't happen against me, but I seem to always just get those really cheapo hits with Ichiro. As we see, Carl Crawford's getting a little dribbler. And then we got Matt Kemp up. Of course, he's swinging and missing. Tanner Roark equals Cy Young, fam. Give this man a Cy Young for this pitching performance. As Reggie Stocker to Corey Seager, as it was a pretty weak throw by Corey, but you know, he gets the job done anyway. As Tanner Roark, man, that curveball of his was just a bubble. He was swinging so early at these curveballs, and I don't really know why, because he doesn't throw that hard. As Joe Mauer, this dude must have been pissed off about this hit, because that was a good swing on a curveball. I thought that was going to get destroyed. And let's see if we just get him on another curveball, and of course we do. It's not even in the strike zone, it's in the dirt. He's still swinging at it. And just this game, it was just, I felt like I was definitely getting more hits than him, but he was definitely leaving out more pitches for me to hit. And this dude was just swinging at a crap load of hits, as Tanner Roark almost gets a hit there. But I don't know how people can, unless you're like really deep into the game, like you really enjoy it, it's all you play. Man, I am just baffled as to how good some of these teams are, like how much money you have to invest in these teams. Like, you really have to be dedicated into playing this game to get a team like this. And this dude, I'm not even knocking him. Like, I'm more impressed with how good of a team. And of course, Adrian Beltre just lets that go. Jose Altuve with the only two hits for his team so far in the sixth inning. But other than Jose Altuve, man, no one else on this team is showing up. I am very surprised that no one dinged me a couple times in this game. But, you know, I'm not even going to complain. As Prince Fielder gets a little nice hit, and then, of course, he's going to dive for it. So, you know, of course the big man's got to go to second base. I mean, why not, you know? So let's see if we can actually get something going here. We got Corey Seager, the GOAT, and jam shot. So we're going to leave Prince all alone at second base, but I have a feeling like, you know, we're definitely getting some solid hits on this man, and he obviously ain't doing anything batting, so swinging and missing with Alex Rodriguez. I heard that Yankees Alex Rodriguez is really crap, though. At least that's just what I've heard. So going to Adrian with a great plate discipline, gonna get walked here. It was a little early, but yeah, he's gonna get walked here. Full count, Matt Holliday. Let's see if we can just get some going, man. We really need some runs here. It's getting really late. The starter's getting tired. Is Matt Holliday's gonna pop up? So that Matt Holliday, who isn't terrible, I might try to go and get that Tony Gwynn. It's Ian Kinsler. If he wouldn't have dove for that, he would have gotten that. People need to sometimes realize that you can't always die for every pitch, because he would have gotten that if he wouldn't have dove. But now we got two men on with one out. And Salty up the bat. Let's see if he can become clutch here.
And boom goes the dynamite.
Salta La Macchia into the gap. Now this base running here was really annoying because I told Ian Kinsler to run home and he just took forever for some reason to start running. So I just told him to stay at third base. As now I'm going to have to sub out Tanner Roark for Freddie Freeman, who's really good. I mean, this Freddie Freeman is really nice. And of course, Freddie Freeman's going to come up clutch off the bench. So now we're up 3-0 against this God Squad. And the pressure is on now, man, because I do not want to choke this game. Ichiro popping up, and the pressure's getting on. I was definitely really swing happy after hitting with Freddie Freeman, as the next pitch, Carl Crawford's going to pop up as well. But now we gotta start. We really need to clamp down in this guy. As now we're gonna bring in John Axford, who I've only used twice. So let's see if we can actually get some going on here. See if we can lead off what Tanner Roark was pitching. And a big pop up, but you know, that's of course it's gonna go to Ichiro. And this John Axford, usually when relievers come in, I get pretty nervous. As the pass ball. And Jackie Robinson, barely safe, but he comes safe, and then just a little dribbler from Alex Rodriguez, and of course this man's gonna have Chipper Jones on his bench, you know, who, I mean, I wasn't all that surprised, but you know, he could become a victim as well into the strikeout. John Axford picking up right where Tanner Roark was starting off. This dude could not hit the curveball. He was swinging at every curveball. As we see, Adrian Beltre, he is getting some nice hits here, and I am very impressed with him. Wait, hold up a second. I think we got another sports center. This is going to be number one right here. Matt Kemp robbing Matt Holliday. It wasn't going to be a home run. It was going to be a double, but that was a clutch save right there because he was going to score if he wouldn't have caught that. So now we're bringing in Raleigh Fingers. I'm not all huge on Raleigh Fingers. He might actually be my long relief pitcher because he has 50 stamina for a closer, which is just ridiculous. You don't need 50 unless you're gonna be a long reliever. So I'm gonna look to see if I can get another closer. And of course, the ninth inning, always super sketchy. Jose Altuve getting on base to lead off, but a little bit of lag. I'm not sure if that helped me out or anything, but the lag definitely wasn't all that useful for him, I guess, because he got caught looking. It could have been the lag, I don't know. As the pitch out almost got him right there, but I didn't notice that he was running back to first base. So Matt Kemp, he's being very patient right now, and I'm getting really nervous because I do not want to leave him on base. So 3-0 count with Reggie Stocker up the bat. As I mess up on the pitch, yet he still swings at it and he gets jammed up. This man had the worst luck this game. And now we got Reggie Stocker up the bat. All we gotta do is get one more out. And I'm getting a little paranoid because I know he's gonna steal that Jose Altuve. But I'm just trying to jam him up, going high and low. I know pitching high may seem really stupid to Reggie Stocker, but it's a part of what I've been doing the entire game, pitching high and low, high and low, high and low. That's what I've been doing the entire time, and he's just been swinging and missing at him. So 2-1, he's stealing, breaking his bat, game over. What a lame way to win the game, but you know what? I was so happy to get this game over with. Tanner Roark pitching the game of his life. I mean, who can say that they struck out A-Rod, Barry Bonds? You know, he pitched in a two-hitter against the God Squad with Tanner Roark. Who's going to say that, fam? 7 innings, 2 hits allowed, 7 strikeouts. Just an amazing game. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. The games aren't usually going to be that long because I decided to fit 2 games in. Here are the box scores. Other than that, guys, you guys have a great day. Please like and subscribe if you like the video. Anyway, I'm out. Peace.